you do. Like, you're playing out.
The hero is very straightforward, but I think the hero that we're, or the player that we're ignoring here that we shouldn't, is Yoku. I think his ventral spirit in that game was very solid. His life stealer in the first game kind of held things together. I think this is.
He's probably the most notable player on Virtus Pro in that first game.
Yeah, exactly. And I think overall, I've seen, this is maybe like the 20th game I've seen this team play together. Feels like he's kind of their new stable player. He's like the answer
to go-to guy.
Yeah, he's like the guy who will always perform at least a decent pace.
Okay, let's drop you into the draft. It is ready. And I believe they are underway with picks and bans. And just the bans for now. So yeah, two standard bans.
The one player on Seeker who I feel like still doesn't look entirely comfortable is Universe. So I don't quite feel like he's completely gelled with his teammates yet since leaving EG. I don't know how you guys feel about that.
I agree. I feel, even at Manila, I heard he was sick. And that's why he was having a little bit of an off time. But here at this event, he still doesn't really feel like he's coming to his own in this team. Part of that, I think, is they want him to probably play a lot different than he did on EG. And that's kind of a little bit of a switch.
Yeah.
Getting used to your support.
It's going
to
take time.
Yeah, exactly. When you have that, it's going to be a little bit off at least.
But also the changes that have been made, obviously, were made very late towards the end of the transfer window. And they're building TI. This isn't necessarily the next major or the next tournament, and that's not to put any of those tournaments down. It's a TI built team, a team built to win TI.
Yeah. And even for Puppy, like, Misery is completely different style of offlaner to what Universe is. Like, as far as comparing offlaners, like, they're the two different extremes of offlaners. So for Puppy, he's probably adjusting to playing with Universe in terms of his draft, because it's a pretty big change to the team overall.
So again, no surprises so far. Bounty gone again. These three actually have started to come barely standard bans in the last couple of days.
Yeah, these three
don't often get through.
And the Beastmaster, which is either banned or first pick. Yeah. So probably see a line, at least if we go back to game one and what Secret have preferred to.
When these four have when these four have been banned, line's been first pick pretty much every time.
It's a safe opener.
Yeah. Doesn't really reveal much, does it?
Yeah, it doesn't really give away any part of your draft.
There it is. Virtus
Pro's turn to pick. Virtus Pro.
It also means you have, like, it assures you've got a lockdown here for some of the popular cores too. Like, well, the Ember Spirit less popular, but the Puck was seeing a lot of play if you go back to, like, previous tournaments and the start of Epicenter as well.
Yeah.
I'm still waiting for that No Fear Earth Spirit. Remaining. They've been kind of ignoring it. I'm not sure if that's just because he's been kind of stuck on the Chen and other heroes like that, and maybe giving more of the active role to FNG with his roaming offlane heroes.
That was a hero. It's like a hero that some teams think is still like the same and still just as good, and then there's other teams like,
we can't excel on this anymore. Yeah.
That's true. The changes. Seems some teams still value him quite highly, and others, I mean, Liquid being the obvious team, he was still first picking the hero.
Complexity as well.
Yeah, then you have, well, teams like EP who have kind of stopped picking the hero altogether. And VP are going to chew through that. Like, this is the time where is most important. These two picks here, they're going to use up their reserve time, because this is going to kind of take the direction their draft kind of heads based on what they get here.
But if you do want to go for something like a Drow strat, you don't want to give away too early on. Like, you don't want to go like Puck Venge or something like that in your first one too.
You could do Venge plus one though.
They will get
there we go.
Virtus Pros turn. I wonder if they want to go for an offlaner, like a Nature's Prophet, Darkseer,
Darkseer Earth Spirit works really well. It's just like early game aggression, pressure on that safe lane hero.
DS or Venge?
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah. I really like Venge, because it still keeps them like adaptable. Allows them to go for a draft strat with like a support Venge, or they can go back for the Yoku one roll.
5 seconds remaining. I just want to see them play aggressive in the laning phase. Yeah. That's why I like Venge. Yes, Venge gives them some options as to how they want to play it. Take Bat too for FNG. Seems like one of the heroes in his wheelhouse.
Bat Rider! Nice.
Yep.
Team Secret's turn to pick.
There we go.
I mean, offlane plus roaming support opener is pretty common for second pick nowadays.
Yeah.
Like, super standard.
I think third round last time?
Batrider?
Second phase last time, yeah. Batrider in the second phase ban? Or was it the first? It was definitely banned, though.
It was first. It would be second phase.
Yeah.
Picked it against EG yesterday, and FNG had some success with it. Reserved. And you can tell, especially with newer offlaners, that they have heroes that they want to play or that they play a lot. So they sometimes you'll see them over rely on just like those three or four heroes because, like, well, these are the ones that I'm comfortable with.
Now it's going to be on secret side, they're going to probably start chewing through their reserve time to decide what they want with this second pick. And
Lingua Revenge?
I mean, picking two supports is like that's secret will often do. Like, their own, just because they want to save their cores to later. The other option is picking up universes here, like getting a Darkseer.
Darkseer has.
Or Nature's Prophet. They did Nature's Prophet in game one in the first stage, was it? They got Nature's Prophet with the lion, so. They'll go Void. The universe is here, but not perhaps the one we were expecting.
Be surprised if they leave the Darkseer in now for Virtus Pro, right?
Most likely they're going to be the Batrider on the offlane. They normally run that for FNG. Mm. They're not a team. They don't want to play G on a tempo controller like Bat. If he's playing mid, they want him something which can utilize farm a bit more, kind of transition into a carry of sorts, and that's not really Batrider for BP. I think with that in mind, you don't need to throw a ban onto the Darkseer. Team secrets. Turn Enigma taken out.
Yeah, that's the hero that I thought that they would grab for themselves. Yeah. Still, Venge is an option. Although Venge Lion is never my favorite support combo.
Do you try and target G here with your bans? Like, at all?
He's a lot of heroes.
Or are you just not afraid of the like heroes that are?
They have a lot more control this game than they did in the last one. Even if he goes for something like the Ember, Faceless Void and Lion are both excellent.
Mm.
I think the best part about these two picks is they're really good against almost all of those mobile-type cores to begin with.
I was thinking like G Invoker. You've got the Lasso into Sunstrike kind of thing once the game gets going. Earth Spirit controls up mid and gives him a good laning stage.
Yeah. Thinking long about this ban. I do know where both these heroes should go, in theory.
Yeah.
They're gonna ban the Yoku.
Virtus pros turn to ban.
I think there's probably a smaller pool of safe lane farmers that work as opposed to like mid. I feel mid is just like a wide open lane in a lot of ways where there's so many heroes that can be viable there. Mm-hmm. Versus like there's a select few that you kind of prefer for your safe lane.
I wonder if Spectre will make her way through the draft, because I think game two she was ignored, game one also not picked or banned.
Definitely good for VP with the Batrider, that's kind of what
that's what I was looking at
like
for Yoku.
Alliance or newbie run a lot, where you've got this Blink Initiator and then you have the Spectre Haunt, just force team fights. Not good with the Faceless Void. I don't imagine Envy would be considering it, but...
Mm-hmm. What do you think about bans? DK?
Oh yeah, I mean, you kind of talked about DK as being one of the emerging heroes.
Team Secrets.
And ET though. ET with the Void, you've got like a good follow-up. It's a puppy hero. I actually quite like that ban.
It's not too greedy either.
Yeah.
We saw how successful he was with it against newbie, and it would be a really nice second phase.
10 seconds remaining.
I think for Secret, they've just gotten a much more stable owner. Like last game, it was like seeing their first 2 to 3 picks, I was just like, this does not look... These three picks have a ton of weaknesses. You see Lion Void, and again, it works against anything. You've got good scaling coming out of the Void. Lion gives you some control as well as burst damage. Just things that the Bane and the Io didn't offer. So Sven gets banned out with the Lifestealer. We see both teams just basically targeting one player. Yoku getting targeted by Secret, and then Puppy being targeted by VP with their bans.
Disruptor. Still think, okay, so Disruptor, obviously one of the best heroes against that Faceless Void. A lot of control factor, you can glimpse him back after the time walk, and they picked it in the last game, and it just feels like a comfort pick for Aloha Dance.
Enchantress.
Oh, hey.
The Enchantress.
Okay.
It's a hero that we don't see too much now. I think it got 5th picked yesterday. It was Liquid, wasn't it? Up against OG.
Yep.
I did a lot of work with it in the initial stages of the game up against Miracles Invoker, but Secret here for Puppy.
10 seconds remaining.
You can definitely kind of trace the movements of Earth Spirit early on, but it's another one of those heroes like Gods was saying in the previous game, where Secret had, you know, two core heroes and then two supports that didn't farm or really do too much with farm, and then an offlaner that was the Clockwork, obviously, but Enchantress can transition from that support role into an actual right-click damage dealer.
Well, VP. Without much thought, I actually pick up Ursa, which is great against both Void and Enchantress. Being able to the Fury Swipe sticking to the Faceless Void even after the time walk, and good hero to burst down an Enchantress as well. So like this pick. They're on the Dire side. They have easy access to Roshan. It's like kind of like a good 1-2 punch with G, because you know they're likely putting G on some kind of carry as well. You don't want Ursa to be your like main 4 protect 1 carry. It just doesn't function in that way. But the role that G plays on this team, I think it works really well as a hero that can create space for G.
I think the best part about this hero too is, again, it kind of fits with the theme where we wanted them to play aggressively. This is a hero that allows you to do really well in the lane with just 1 or 2 supports. That means the Ursa can roam around and start to get an advantage in the other 2 lanes. It's a hero that can offer you the really early Roshan, of course. More importantly than that, it has the ability to scale a little bit longer. It functions well as kind of that off-core that Virtus Pro like to take.
It pairs well with the Disruptor too.
Okay, that's what we thought that they would take coming into the ban phase, which we expected VP to ban, but they went for the ET instead.
Much more stable draft from Secret. Like I like what VP is doing here by all means, but Secret have just gone with something pretty cookie cutter. The Faceless Void, perhaps the one kind of mix up to some extent, but again, this is a universe classic and something they'll be very comfortable on.
They know it's going to be TK maybe.
Secret, Klink's Void.
5 seconds. I think that's a good idea. I actually
trying to think
really
of
like
here.
That.
I feel like your last hero needs to be. Like, you've got already got the Enchantress. DK can go like Dragonlance if you really want some extra range to help. I guess I don't know. That's something we were theory crafting earlier. But you've got okay damage in the Chronosphere. But I feel like the last pick you want to add a bit more with.
I think Klink's or. I guess Disruptor's pretty okay against Slark. I'm okay with either of those options. The only hard disable that you have to worry about is the Blasso. Team secrets
turn to pick. I guess Earth Spirit is like for Slack as well. There's also Earth Spirit though.
A little bit of a nuisance. Final hero for Secret.
There's still an Ember Spirit as well, which is like your envy classic. But to me, the Klink's just fits the overall draft a bit better. 5 seconds remaining. Oh. See soon enough what Team Secret Reserve think they can round the draft with, and they have the ability of they can take objectives. They've got the DK ultimate form. They've got the Enchantress who can apply pressure early on, gives them some extra pushing power as well. 5 seconds. Jackie's hero is going to be Weaver.
That was an option last time round. They didn't take it.
Yeah.
Disruptor, this time they do.
That's kind of scary though, isn't it?
Yeah, Disruptor's good against this hero for quite a long time.
Bat and Earth Spirit as well? Pre-Lincolns especially.
Yeah.
Nice way to risk is your silence and your stun don't count Lincolns with these. You initiate with your silence stun, like you're going to disable the Weaver.
Then also
getting a Shikuchi off, yeah. But, and the Weaver we saw earlier today looked very underwhelming.
Tinker.
What do we have for Tinker?
Void Chrono.
Void Chrono. I mean, Blink Dragonite Lion, but I like VP's draft.
Interesting draft at the end. Got two heroes we don't see an awful lot of, although Weaver seems to have been creeping back into the meta in the last couple of days. What's up with Gareth? Where's the favor lie this time?
EP, so long as G doesn't die five times in the first 5 minutes.
Okay, that's
because
slightly
Puppy,
hedging your bets.
Has Enchantress.
I see where you're going with it. All right, okay, we'll allow that one.
I think Secret have just gone for a much more well-rounded draft. They're the better team, so I give them the slight edge, even though I do like VP's draft a lot. I think Secret have just a strong draft. Other than the Weaver pick, I'm a little iffy on, but
okay.
I think Secret will take it.
He doubts the Weaver pick. You like the Weaver pick?
I think it's okay. It's a little bit item-dependent, but I still think the rest of the lineup is a lot more stable. They have plenty of ways to catch
a bit more
the tanker.
Standard.
Yeah, and I think draft-wise and team-wise, I favor Secret.
Okay, all right. We're fairly unanimous on the panel once again, except that Gareth sort of goes with VP, but only if G decides not to die in the first 5 minutes. Let's find out how he gets on as we go back to our commentary team. Purge versus Toby.
Thank you very much, Red. Yes, we're back here for our deciding game. Team Secret up against Virtus Pro. VP pushing us to a third game. Purge.
Not what we expected, really.
No, not at all.
Especially towards the end of that last game, I was like, you know, I really don't know how this is going to go. It could go both ways. Could have been a cool upset. It wasn't, but Well, it was, but then it wasn't afterwards.
Yeah.
Which was kind of fun.
It's the fun game. It's the game of swings.
It really was. Secrets Draft is a lot more standard this game compared to what they normally do. A lot of their core heroes, it's the first time we've seen Universe play Faces Void in a while. He's known to be one of the best players in the world of it, and he's got very expensive cosmetic items as well.
So obviously that makes him a more powerful offlane player. 30
seconds. Yeah, something like that. He's already got Lightning Hammer. Like, he doesn't even have to buy one, dude. Pretty cool.
doesn't need to be on you. It's going good.
But yeah, the Tinker definitely could be really good this game, but there is great catch coming from Secret and lots of good early roam from Enchantress. So how effective that stuff is going to change a lot. But pretty much no matter what, Secret's always going to have a solution against the Tinker. They just have to blow him up first, and then they're in a good spot. With that said, though, the Ursa is so good against a lot of Secret's heroes in the laning stage, so he could be very valuable here.
First round of the contest, VP were thinking about trying to stop Envy, maybe catching him out if you try to snipe out that bottom rune, but it's just gonna be normal rune trade-offs. And lanes are pretty normal, so got Tinker up against the Arteezy DK in the mid lane, as Dirk was pointing out. You gotta be looking for that Enchantress rotation, watch to see where she's effective. Universe offlane, Aloha's gonna be supporting Yoku, who's the safe lane Ursa. And then offlane, FNG's Batrider for Virtus Pro. Up against the dual safe lane with the Lion as well as the Weaver.
The Batrider plus Ursa combo is gonna be so good in the mid to late game, because whenever they actually grab somebody, they're gonna be able to blow them up instantly, the blink on the Ursa. And in the laning stage, Ursa is very good against Faces Void. Mid game, late game, Ursa is very good against Enchantress as well. So if Yoku has a good game here and doesn't get just kind of chain bursted down by his opponents, then he's gonna constantly remain an effective hero against his opponents.
Probably gonna be a little bit sad about this. He managed to pick himself up a Hellbear, and he was coming for his second creep. The sentry ward's already planted down, so...
Okay, so he grabbed at the other large camp, clearly.
Yep, no fear.
Oh, this is cool.
he's trying to make sure he can't deward it and open up the camp.
Yeah,
that was, Poppy doesn't that have another awesome. Sentry ward available either.
That was such a sick play. Was he hiding on the high ground so he could see the sentry go down?
Yep.
And as soon as he saw it, he rolls in, eats it with the tango, instantly wins the sentry battle. And now Puffy's ability to be aggressive on the safe lane, at the very least, is severely limited. So now No Fear just has to protect this other large camp, and then he's all set. And this slows down Puffy. This could potentially have been Tinker dying if he got another creep here, for all you know.
Yeah, and that's the big thing. God having space, getting up to BT, so VP will always have support, create more space on the map, so then Yoku can, one, easily grab Roshan, but, like, two, you've got big rotations to come up. Like, FNG, when he can get that Blink Dagger timing up and running, you can get really aggressive up against Secret, and if Enchantress doesn't have anything to fight with, then it's not going to be the Faceless Void we're looking forward to initiate. Or the DK hitting level 6 attacking the tower, it's going to be Secret on the defense just trying to hold the line. Not actually making the plays.
So it can go a lot of different ways, like you said. For now, levels, Batrider's got nothing, but he will be catching up a bit here. Unless they change and deny everything. So FNG's slightly tough time in the offlane, whereas Faces Void's basically been able to fight for experience this entire time. And that's kind of because Disruptor's glimpse range isn't very long, so if you're not behind the Faces Void as you chase him down with Ursa, it's kind of hard to grab that kill. Mm-hmm. But once he gets level 3, it's going to be a lot easier. The range will be so high that Ursa can hit him a couple times, he'll time walk away, glimpse will send him back, and they should be able to chase him down and kill him. And no boots yet for Void, so...
I still want
to
keep my eyes on Puppy. Like, he's managed to get himself a small army. The Hellbear was harassing No Fear, who just ran halfway across the map.
That was a cool play by Puppy, that he just put a creep on him, said, this is gonna chase you forever, and now we know where you are, and you can't do anything until this, unless you stand under a tower, I guess.
But does Puppy even have a play? Like you got a Centaur stun, not the most reliable of things to get off in a team fight.
Isn't?
For a Roman gank.
But they do have Dragonite stun, hypothetically. He hasn't skilled it yet, but... definitely gank with that, and he could maybe try to do safe lane. That one's kind of hard. Batrider can just fly over trees and stuff. Mm-hmm. For now, he's just prioritizing on farming, for sure. He can get levels. If they're shutting down his roam, then yeah, maybe you won't get that advantage, but at least you can get your levels, and then you'll do better mid-game due to having impetus.
I just feel a little bit iffy about this. Eternal Envy's got 6 sticky napalm charges up on him. Obviously, he's got Shikuchi and 10-1 charges to get away. FNG wasn't looking too healthy either, because he had the swarm on him.
I mean, killing Envy is almost impossible. Unless Envy tries to kill the Batrider, that's pretty much the only way FNG gets that one.
Here's that smoke maneuver. Pilot Eye and Puppy, they're on the rotate. They've only got 32 seconds left on this Centaur.
This is the setup here.
They came over the Radiant Observer Ward. So they wait. They have to wait till FNG comes down further. So now Pylai die. He'll start with the Hex. The stun's available as well. They take the Invis rune. Or actually, they should probably take the Invis rune so FNG can't just pick that one up and walk away with it as Puppy. He's using it as bait for FNG to come to. But the Centaur's not there to stop. The burst is not there.
Yeah, they were slightly on the different page. I think what happened was Puppy wanted to wait for the bat to go for the rune. Then they'd set up there. But because the smoke broke on the Chen creeps, Pylai die ran at him. They needed to be on the same page no matter what they did there.
Well, now they slip in between the tier 1 and tier 2 tower. It is nighttime, so they're able to do this without getting scouted out. Universe giving some information of No Fear, who's moving towards the high ground. And this time, okay, they're going to come down and try and help him out. No Fear's still got Boulder away. They can't get a stun on him, so he's just up into the tree line. And God also just goes the long way around back into the dire jungle.
That was a really good read that those heroes would be there. So otherwise, for sure, somebody dies. FNG rotates over. They can potentially chase these guys all the way home. But spending a lot of resources just protecting mid, which is what they needed to do. Camps get stacked as well, so...
A waste of time for VP.
We'll see if it goes to Batrider or the Tinker, though. That's one of the downsides of this lineup, is both of these heroes do want to catch up or accelerate by getting stacks, and only one person is going to be able to do that. And No Fear as well is really far behind on Burstbird. He's only level 1 this whole time.
Well, every single rotation he's had has been not useful, and yep, there's suicide.
Might as well go back to base. He's got new stuff to buy, wards to get out without having to use courier. So he's got to get some levels soon, though. Tome won't make up for this by itself.
But the upside is the fact you still have like Ursa and Aloha's getting a lot of experience on the top lane.
Yep.
Like they're pulling, and this is pretty much a safe lane. And Eternal Envy, who normally likes to get a little bit more aggressive on his Weaver play, like he was the one that loved building early phase boots, for example. Just instantly pound into whoever the offlaner is, use the time-lapse every time it's off cooldown. He's not finding that opportunity because VP have just moved off the lane. FNG actually started farming the Radiant jungle.
And that's one of the downsides to Weaver, is that you can get aggressive early, but...
I think this is dead. Puppy's coming in with the extra help.
He's got a
double Centaur, but he needs to body block and slow him down. God just wants to keep running. There's a March Machines. No Fear's coming in over. And with the disrupt the wall, Puppy can't keep chasing. In fact, God now just starts to March the Machines, farming while he's actually defending the choke point, too. And with an extra vision from the Dire Observer Ward, there is no chance here for Team Secret. And that's with the double damage rune and the DK form being triggered.
So yeah, Tinker was just going here to farm, guys. That was totally standard stuff going on. Look for the Dior.
Oh, they stop him. That's the play right there. No Fear, he's making a break for the stack. He's actually going to get denied up by the big stack that's there. It reveals the presence of the stack, but it denies first blood to Team Secret.
Yeah, nobody's died yet. It's pretty surprising. Even if he did die, he wouldn't give much gold or experience.
TP's coming in. You're probably going to see death in a moment. First TP actually being cancelled, and FNG trapped in by the Centaur. Both of them stunning. It took forever for Yoku to arrive, and now he attacks over towards the DK. A lot of stacks on him, and the DK can't run out. The wall comes up, and DK will pop to the Disruptor. They'll glimpse back over on Puppy. The giveaway first blood of the Batrider, but now Tinker gets the kill, and Destructor picks one up too, with the first rotation of Yoku ending with a mid-tier 1 tower denial.
Losing the tower is the part that makes me a little unsure if that was perfect for VP. The cancelled TP hurt pretty bad, actually. Was that G, maybe? I thought it was Blue, but obviously that's Puppy. Puppy can't TP. I'm not sure who was that cancelled. If it was Tinker, he may have been able to rearm his TP if he bought a second one. But ultimately, a great fight for them, getting two kills. They did lose their tower, but that's pretty standard for Dragon Knight. And the hard part is, though, is their heroes that gank now are very behind on levels. Batrider as well as Urspirit.
This is the reason why Batrider's on the top lane, but this gank can work. You've got to keep that sticky napalm up on Universe. He's still going to time walk out. Yoku rotates over. You have to dive under the town. There's no glimpse available. And with the TP support now being pulled in from Team Secret, actually, again, another TP that gets cancelled.
That glimpse cooldown is too long, and he stopped the cooldown from going through using time dilation, but I'm sure Universe is pretty scared there.
Eternal Envy is itching for a kill on this bot lane. But very wise from No Fear, holds back at the tier 2 tower, not giving Eternal Envy any kind of opening for this.
He has picked up level 2, happy to announce. For him?
Yay! Progress at 8 minutes and 20 seconds.
Yeah.
It might be enough if he can boulder and get that nice kick onto the Dragon Knight. Oh.
That's difficult. There's an invis on DK anyways. Literally no way they kill this guy. We'll see. Dives your fountain, maybe.
If you had the last Sue on FNG, then...
Even then, they don't have the damage for it. They'd have to lasso him into the tower and then have someone there that actually does do damage, like Ursa. And Ursa's going phase Morbid Mask, not too surprising. Now, he is a good hero here, but Roche was nerfed in the last patch. He doesn't give as much experience, so Ursa's definitely a weaker hero than he was previously. doesn't scale as well, and now he won't be able to accelerate levels as rapidly either. Mm-hmm. But in pro games, maybe this doesn't matter, because pro teams very often, they do protect each other.
FNG, that's not where he really wants to be. Dragon Tail, he waited as long as he possibly could for it. Breathe Fire still available. 3 points up in it. One attack and the Breathe Fire should be enough. The kick from No Fear as she's silencing him up, allowing for at least No Fear to boulder himself away. But the Breathe Fire still catches up the Batrider. This is the Batrider desperately scrambling for level 6. Something.
Yeah. I mean, they gave all that acceleration to Tinker, and even then, he doesn't even have Boots of Travel quite yet. He's getting kind of close. He's got his Soul Ring ready. He's got some of his levels, but got two heroes that are completely gimped on VP side, and it's Batrider and Urspirit. Affects him so much. Look where Dragonite's playing. Like, he just knows there's no damage threat unless Ursa's there. That's basically it. So Ursa gets his Blink Dagger or gets a good wraparound, it's hard.
Chronosphere over in Aloha Dance. Puppy's coming in as well. No impetus available, but he's going to give enough assist damage to make sure that Aloha Dance will go down. So, Universe, think about how successful he'll be compared to the Batrider. Right now, Universe is looking in a very comfortable position.
And I wonder how much better this would have been if No Fear laned against Void, for example. Like, with Glimpse, wrap the Disrupt around all the way, force the slow and the leap with Universe there, and then send it back with Glimpse after. Maybe that might have been better. But he basically just sat mid to protect G, and now he's actually gimped himself so much. I think he just used the experience so many, he's almost 5. He's still so far from 6.
Top tower is under attack. It's definitely not going to be easy for the VP support. So now they try and take Roshan. The Observer Ward from Team Secret scab this out. They're also getting a trade off. Universe is going to kill off this tier 1 tower on the top lane. There's all tier 1 towers removed 11 minutes into the game. So Roshan's taking a long time to kill. They're finally going to get rid of that Obs up on the hillside. So it's a little bit more blind to the map for Secret, but looks like they don't even really care.
Yeah, they're going to get it anyways. I guess they don't feel comfortable fighting here, especially because they just used Chronosphere. Maybe the one good thing about Disruptor dying there.
Wait, here they come. No Fear getting caught with the initial stun. There's still a Hex available too. He goes to the initial kick, Eternal Envy. The Swarm currently on No Fear. He'll get up. The Gemini will follow him. The Swarm's almost killing him at the moment. He's down to 23 life. Can't get it off. Weaver's going to take it out. Disruptor, the ulti is beautiful. But then Disruptor, the stun came in from Pylai Dai. Creates more space. They lasso onto Arteezy. So he will drop. But Yoku's already burnt the Aegis Immortal. While Puppy, he's hunting himself. Tinkers on the back line. Eternal Envy got himself a double kill. It was first the Earth Spirit. Then he moved over to the Disruptor. So both the supports dying, and Universe once more, he's chasing FNG a little bit further down while Yoku's being chased by Eternal Envy. We're on all fronts, Tinker, TP's in, trying to create a march to the machines, a little bit more of a cover fire. Yoku is going to die to Eternal Envy underneath the tier 2 tower, tries to turn and fight, see if actually burn through his Aegis, you burn through his life, and the stun from Puffy, the Mud Golem is still up, you almost want this thing to die, so you got another two stuns available. Universe has to time walk out, Chrono's up in 1 second time, so we can turn this one onto FNG. The damage to Eternal Envy's on the edge of it, but he will tie. The Tinker brings in enough damage, combining it with the Thunderstrike there of Aloha Dance. Eternal Envy has to bail out. As one scrambling long fight, almost skirmishes. Tons of heroes going down on either side.
Yeah, the Ursa's just so weak against Weaver. Weaver can do whatever he wants against him. The very low chance that he gets the kill, and if he throws the bugs on him as well, it's just, you always know where he is. You're lowering his armor, you're doing physical damage. So Envy's gotten a really efficient early item build as well. This is like the new drum, basically, on a lot of agility heroes. Gives you more strength and more agility than the previous drum ever did. Only works on range. That's the only downside.
Luckily, he is a ranged hero with very little lockdown against him, so Dragon Lance is perfect.
And Tinker's been doing a great job. They protected him so much, and now he's covering his allies. When you throw down March, it becomes very hard to fight in it. And that's what we saw there. Just a lot of March in the machines. Luckily, they're able to use their ultimates to pick off DK, by far the hardest hero to kill. But even then, they have pretty good solutions. He's got high armor, but Ursa does cut through it eventually.
Wow.
Finger of Death.
Hello, bottom lane. And maybe even goodbye God. One more attack from Pylai's Eye would do it. God makes a break for the tree line, bottling up. So now no longer one more attack.
That would have been such a sick kill if you solo killed the enemy mid. The level 6 support.
Power Finger of Death.
Yeah, that's a big cooldown on that spell. The fact that he didn't get the kill is really going to limit Secret now. They're pretty much relying on Chronosphere again.
Yeah, and it's VP's time to be the aggressors. You've got that Blink Dagger now over on FNG. So the Batrider can jump and initiate. He's looking over towards Universe, and there's a lot of support rotating over. Yoku's already prepared off that overpower. So FNG, Blink, Lasso, all he needs to do is hold Universe in position. With a Disrupt the Wall, they'll make sure Universe goes nowhere. Really
nice.
A lot
game.
Of all these committed, but still gonna work.
Yeah, he had to be patient there and wait for the setup. If he went in a bit earlier, they wouldn't have the silence, and Void would have absolutely lived. So another kill happens, and that should turn into a tier 1 tower top, or at least force Secret to rotate some of their heroes over.
Right now, Secret, they don't even want to do that. Envy still wants to keep farming up that bottom lane, adding more pressure. Is that Shadowblade done? It is actually Shadowblade done over on the Dragon Knight.
Okay. It's an Arteezy special, basically. He can go around getting kills. He could have gone Armlet this game, but it's not as good because VP Da has so many magic nukes. All of their heroes except for Ursa, they're almost entirely magic-based. So if he goes Armlet, the armor advantage you get from it isn't the same. So he'd rather grab Shadowblade, that way he can go around getting kills and accelerating in other ways.
Team Secret just scanned inside the Dire jungle. They're looking for the farming Ursa. Funny enough, the scan was just a little bit too far to the east, but when that smoke is going to break, your Shadow Blade allows you so to come close. In close, but Yoku already retreated back out again. And this is nighttime, remember. Yeah. With the Observer Ward down, they see more, and they actually saw the Courier going out. It doesn't really have a lot on it, it's just going to deliver the items to Nofear, but Universe, Chrono up, he can catch out too. Aloha Dance, well, I suppose that's one way to cancel off the TP. Dragon Tower would probably also suffice.
Not a bad loss there. Better him than both. Well, they did scan and actually caught Puppy, so it kind of revealed the fact that there were already a bunch of heroes in the jungle. Could have been much worse, though. So with that, FNG, he's going to push the other lane out.
TZ can't really follow this up. If he was able to get that initial stun, it would have been fine, but his Shadowblade was on cooldown just as FNG was walking down the mid lane.
Yeah, and Disruptor is a low level, so he'll be up again in a second, and in the meantime, VP's still farming. Now, Envy is ahead. Got 8k gold here, and he's getting close to a Lincoln Sphere, so it's going to be very hard for VP to kill him in the future. Until Batrider gets 4 staff, and then he's in trouble again. And that's kind of the period where VP wants to hit. They got to hit that sweet spot of breaking the Lincolns again, and then it's going to be hard for Secret to push. Mm-hmm. For now, they're fine. They can take this tower easy.
Yep. Well, then again, VP, smoke up. They're coming to defense. Every ulti available, Tinker's gonna try and chip him down. It's a level 3 rocket, and there's your jump in. They picked up the DK Universe. No Chronos, we just tried to use time dilation to split up this fight, but Pumping is down. Arteezy will join him, and Virtus Pro. At least they got stomped up, but there's more kills. Eternal Envy being dragged back by the glimpse. But thanks to Shikuchi, he continues to run out. Paladize TP will complete, and that tier 2 tower remains alive on the top lane.
Nicely done. The smoke makes all the difference there. Their ultimates come up in time, and they take a fight. The Dragonite was definitely the best person to grab. He was most farthest forward. Again, they have tons of magic and nukes. They just kill him like nothing happened. But I think he did have to go Shadowblade. I'm not going to criticize him for this here. I mean, maybe he could have gone BKB, but it's quite a bit more expensive than Shadowblade. Yeah, they would have won that fight hypothetically if he had the BKB, but same could have been said about his Shadowblade ganks earlier. If those found a hero, then those would accelerate him far faster than a BKB does.
Wouldn't you then expect him to go for like a little bit more life? Because right now I'm just seeing a casual glove in his inventory.
It's either Maelstrom or Midas. The Midas is a possibility because Dragonite doesn't always accelerate super fast from this stage, and Arteezy usually likes to farm more than that. I think they can sense the game is going to go late, basically, but
Aloha.
Maelstrom possible.
Goes into Dragon form, still got Freeze Fire. Aloha Dance, however, had one charge, so the damage was not enough from Arteezy
really
to
now.
Find the kill, and it's VP to counter-initiate. Yoku comes in, and that's a very, very dead Arteezy. Paladai was trying to reach him to help out, but the creep wave just blocked him out.
Counter gank's so good that he just TP's in with Tinker and stops him from attacking. And now Arteezy going this build is now even farther behind. But that's mostly because these ganks aren't quite working out. And he keeps getting killed by all the nukes on VP. The one solution to this tanky armor meta, just get magic spells. Burst people down. The game just gets better later and later for VP, because they're always going to have Lasso. It's almost a guaranteed kill every single time, especially with a hero like either Earth Spirit or Disruptor. They can change it up. Either one can be there and they get a kill.
This Batrider needs to get the Lasso on bottom. They see the Swarm, so they're probably expecting Eternal Envy just be retreating like the way he is.
If they call this out right,
they're a little too late. They're a little too late.
I think that was because Ursa was running to the right and Batrider has less day vision, so they didn't actually see him as he walked past. They maybe could have killed him there. It would have been close.
Aloha starts to push in the lane. Nofear will come and join him. The level 2 Nofear 10 minutes ago is now level 8.
Yeah, that's basically comeback experience. You know, once you start winning fights, everything goes well. But if they did lose those first couple fights, he would have been still behind. Now that he's 6, he's having a great time. He's set on levels, more or less.
Well, Team Secret are ready to group up and fight. You have Universe, who's actually building the pipe for his team now. Instead of going Blink Dagger or Agonyms or anything like that, he's trying to actually like build a little bit of like resistance for the Team Secret lineup.
I like that. I mean, it looks weird on paper, but normally you buy Vlads, and that's kind of the same item. You buy it so that your team does better.
There's so much of VP down here, the lasso. They catch out Puppy. Rupert coming over from the Dragonite. They're trying to get rid of the Observer one, take out the Vision. Puppies are going to go down the Chronosphere from Universe.
Can't
get two, but the damage from the March, not to mention Magnetize, making it difficult. No fear. You'll pop out from Puppies. It's this Mud Golem who came in through the rear, sniping that one. But you've still lost your Lion. You've still lost your Enchantress. Chronosphere is down. And the DK hiding behind the trees. The March cuts off the retreat area. And FNG just jumps in. They'll try and then fight them inside the Shadow Blade, protection now for the Dragon Knight. Universe wants to time walk himself out. He's the main man who's visible. Then Yoku just pounces on him. They'll move into the tier 1 tower as well. And everyone else from Team Secret will TP out. But big fight for Virtus Pro going their way.
No kidding. This is looking like VP's going to win this game. On the trajectory they're at right now, they have got this one in the bag. The only thing that's a little iffy is Weaver. He might get a soul kill here. Huge kill for Envy on the top lane. Turning things around there and accelerating himself past where the Tinker is. And the Lincoln's paying off as well to stop the right clicks from Weaver. What a big kill. He was set up for that one.
This really is like the thing. Like the panel was saying it, like Eternal Envy, there's not a lot of control. With the Lincoln Sphere up, Batrider has a harder time hitting on him, but Envy's able to have a little bit of space. If he can actually get into a bigger damage dealing item, he can start sniping off heroes pretty quickly.
And he hits pretty hard right now. He's got super stat efficient items.
Aloha, goodbye. Oh, maybe not. Okay, maybe yes, goodbye. This is the other way I was thinking. Threw down the Storm Tranky Pilot Eye away from him, but it looks like they're going to give the Lancet over towards the Lion.
Okay.
And just an easy pick off on a Disruptor.
It's too much needed kills for Secret. Even if they're killing supports at this stage, it's great because the gold advantage is on their opponents. Well, not anymore, actually.
It's actually back to zero now.
Well, that's because Secret. Okay, and it's going to jump back up. So it was a Secret advantage, but VP kept getting kills and winning team fights. So I really like the March of the Machines is working out really good against Void. It's like, oh, go ahead, Chronosphere. And at that point, there's two marches set up and they can't follow up on that damage. It's been really effective providing that kind of Void counter. So definitely was worth it for the Urspirit to sacrifice early so that Tinker was set. Now they have a full game going. They can use G's amazing individual skill. We saw it last game to try to pull the win out for their team.
Yep.
And they've got good ganking heroes. Again, FNG continues to grab himself teamfight gank heroes. Mm-hmm. And they've got good damage output from their supports and great utility all around.
Yeah, sustain is beautiful too. With the new Bloodstone changes, this Tinker, like, that looks to be the item which God's also going for.
Yeah.
They have so much to work with. And VP, they're not going to let up on the aggression. Everyone comes to the mid. They got two smokes on a low hard dance. I don't know if God really needs to be smoked up for this.
No, definitely not. He's going to have to show in lanes and push, otherwise it's really obvious. And besides, he can still TP to lanes at any moment. Yeah. Kind of like a Spectre in that way. Just be moving around, getting stuff done, and making sure that Dragonite doesn't find him. That's really where Arteezy wants to go.
Here's the smoke maneuver, VP. Roshan is alive, but Puppy left one skeleton warrior, the lone knight, watching Roshan. So if they kill him, they're going to flag it pretty instantly. So Yoku...
Do they notice?
He's got a double damage rune. Like, the second you see that, I don't think Secret even believe they can get there in time to stop Roshan from dying.
Sometimes you don't even notice. It looks like they did. They smoked, but... They're coming.
But God's prepped up the March Machines. No fears nearby. They make more skeleton minions to scout out. In comes the Swarm. Gonna connect over on Yoku. Roshan's still insanely low, and in comes Universe with the ulti from Aloha Dance. Universe as well. He can't get the ulti off thanks to the lasso from FNG. Aegis Ball in the hands of the Ursa. No fear comes in. He turns on the Magnetize. Universe has to bail out, but he has no choice. He comes back in again thanks to the glimpse. Finger of Death will help out a little bit, but Yoku still wants to just keep battling. But with the help of God, Eternal Envy can't find any kills. They TP out. You got a Warlock from Aloha as well, so we can keep Eternal Envy away.
Oh, what a
they
static.
Have the vision up the hill thanks to the Observer Ward. But you can't chase that.
VP played that so well. That many March of the Machines and GTP'd out just in time. He did a blink TP because he knew once they had vision, they were going to jump in Chrono. If he gets caught in that, the whole fight's over if they're able to kill the Tinker. But he jumps out at the perfect moment. An amazing sounds from Aloha Dance on the Disruptor there. He caught him, delayed the Chrono. They almost killed him before the Chrono. Such a sick fight from VP. They're playing better than Seeker right now.
They really are, and man, I want to put like a lot of credit into Aloha Dance. We've seen like Lions being banned out and a whole bunch of other support heroes being banned out in this competition, but it almost feels like you have to respect ban this disruptor. He is just so good, so quick on his reactions. Yeah. The second the fight begins, it's not just a scared oldie, I've got to throw this down now on one hero. It's such purpose to it as well, and he knows what's going to happen, and FNG syncs with him too.
And it's not just the fact that it silences, it's also that it ends up doing a lot of damage. It's the most clear thing ever. This guy is going to be stunned and silenced for like 3 to 5 seconds, somewhere in there. So burst him down now while you can. And that kind of focus, even though they use Lasso and Batrider died immediately afterwards, it absolutely got them what they needed.
I'm still wondering if they can keep it up once Eternal Envy gets his damage dealing item, though. Like, Envy is still 601. He is the highest net worth on the field. Once he just couldn't kill anyone quick enough to actually change the momentum of that battle.
He has some options. I think he honestly might have to get a fast MKB. I don't like saying that because it's not the highest damage item, but what it would allow him to do is interrupt the Tinker Rearms, which means he can't keep casting spells, and it could also interrupt his TP. And that's something that he's really lacking with. And in fact, a lot of Secret, they don't have that many stuns. It's Chronosphere, Lions, Disables, and the Dragonite. If he gets MKB, he can consistently kill the Tinker by himself. So I think it has to be something like that. It's either that or Deso to just try to out-damage him before he gets out. But the mini bashes are really important. If he buys that and he finds Tinker, Tinker doesn't get out unless he gets a Ghost Scepter or something like that.
You know, it's a hard time, though, when you rely on RNG in order to shut down God.
It's not that bad RNG, though. It's like 35% chance or something like that. And he attacks very rapidly. 35% chance to do 160 magic damage. That's like a nuke. And he can Geminate attack that. It's not a terrible item on Weaver. It's just Deso is far cheaper and far better for the value. It's just, but this game, he needs a way to stop the rearm. Because Tinker, the more times he rearms, better the fights go. It makes Dragonite completely worthless. Like, he just gets bursted down. It doesn't matter that he has Armlet and Shadowblade and high armor. Mm-hmm. He just gets nuked down by the laser missile repeatedly.
But do you actually then try and protect your net worth? Like, we keep talking about like how we think Team Secret can win through damage dealing items on Weaver. What if Envy then just says, you know what, I want to go a BKB. I want to try and survive through everything else. Not going
to
happen.
Yeah, he doesn't have to worry about surviving. He has to worry about killing his opponent's cores. Like, yeah, they have good catch items. But when you go a tank item at this stage on Weaver, when he's already bought Dragonlance, which is semi-tank, semi-DPS, but both Lincolns and Dragonlance are the same. They're efficient HP items that keep you more survivable while still giving you some damage. He needs the damage item.
Lane gonna go on a Aloha Dance. Puppy has no mana to help him though. And in fact, he actually used his stick charge to give him one impetus, but Aloha Dance, he's got Veil to buff him up. The
four
star out from FNG. They commit a Chrono for this, and now Universe. Well, the stun was there from the Mud Golem, but no fear steal here. They slow him up, and Yoko will finish the job. Goodbye, Universe. And Aloha Dance will survive.
Yeah, your disruptor should not be surviving in those kinds of little fights there. It looked like Puppy kind of ran out of mana as well, because he wasn't able to finish him off, but...
He used one charge, so he got one impetus. And that was all.
And this is the other problem with Hood. Not enough mana. Oh, there it is.
No
fear. He did go Deso.
Another support move, Saint Low Life. He gets the silence over on the DK. You've still got the armor to help out, but God... Oh, okay. It's not going to help out at all. It's Weaver on the back lines, sniping out the retreating support heroes, giving himself another kill, and then just retreating away.
So with the Deso, he can now kill the supports much easier. We saw in that fight, Earth Spirit dropped almost immediately. And Earth Spirit going Blade Mail this game. I like this choice. It'll give him something to do against the Weaver when Weaver gets on top of him.
Also stops Puppy from just freely attacking him out. And yeah, make him think twice about their targets.
So G continues to farm 8-1-4 now. Got 12 Bloodstone charges, because that's what you start with. But lots more mana now. And after this, it gets more scary for Secret. He's going to buy Dagons, E-Blades. Heroes like Enchantress, who are weak to burst nukes, they've got to be really careful. Faces Void transitioning from Hood straight into Fusil Blade. I think he kind of realized now that he's past the value where Pipe would have been good. They've already lost those like early game team fights. If he got a really fast Pipe, they would have just rolled over VP in that first engagement. But it came a little late. It's an expensive item, though. Takes a while to get.
Yeah. Also, the survivability as well, just having the casual Hood of Defiance is helping him. We saw that in the mid lane before. Pylite dying, initiated on the top. Flame Break, just going to bounce him around a little bit. And the Glimpse, that'll pull him back all the way. DP support was coming, but you've already lost your line.
Yeah. The Earth Spirit Disruptor combo is just so multi-dimensional. They kind of cover the same bases, both having stuns,
Is Yoki picking up this himself?
But...
FNG's coming down. He's gonna four star. He triggers the dust straight away. So they still see the move. The move of the Dragonite and Yoku blinks off cooldown. He's gonna get in range, and now, yep, beat the living crap out of the Dragonite.
Oh my god.
Hey, that Ursa is so big. Team Secret are actually looking right now at being locked into the lower bracket.
Something nobody expected. And
they were the one team that did really well against Nubi. They had some games that made it really close. But Secret is still the team from playing behind. We saw it last game. Even if this game goes super late, Secret can win this. They've got great late game heroes. Lion, Faceless Void,
FNG,
Enchantress.
Say hello to Puppy, four staff him up, God starts to march machines. If you bring support into this, you die. Aloha Dance even saw the TP coming through down the storm straight away. They just have like a spam field. You just can't get through that much. And then the initiations are coming left, right, and center. Like, you build a Shadow Blade first over on a DK to try and find that initiation, and it turns the other way. Whereas VP were always the one setting the tone of this game.
Yeah, maybe he should have gone Blink Dagger instead. Would have been less expensive. Still can catch the Tinker, like Blink Dagger Armlet perhaps, but they needed that first fight to go well by Roche. But VP won it handily. Well, I mean, it went semi-even, but they got Aegis, and they used that advantage to ultimately win the team fight. They're just very limited by a lot of things. Their only good damage dealer is Weaver. Dragonite is too countered by the nukes. It's hard for them to kill Tinker. VP's just setting up every fight with tons of March spam, and then they get lassoed. You know,
yep.
There's so many ways to get punished by VP's draft.
You are reaching a point where Eternal Envy could start looking to pick up that Monkey King bar you were talking about. Combining it up with the Desolator, this will give him enough damage to be scary in the fights. More and more damage is arriving for VP. You now actually get a Dagon build as the choice here from God.
This is where things get even worse for Envy, because there's another way to break the Lincolns, basically. Two scans, both of them spotting heroes from each team.
Yeah, so they both know, but that Observable is still on the hillside. Yoku very much exposed.
Oh,
the sun's gonna be there. FNG has to create space.
Oh no!
Universe blows the Chrono, but no fear also pulled into it. So he'll get fingered down. They lock down the Dragonite with the last two, allowing the Ursa to go to work, and he jumps forward.
He got Envy.
Universe and Pylite die. There's no surviving. And even Envy locked inside the altar from Aloha Dance. He'll run towards the tower. There's a short moment when they had vision. Now the green wave gives it to him. They glimpse it back over. Envy, time lapse, but then he's back underneath the tier 2 tower. Yoku keeps the chase going. They're trying to slow him down if they can. Shikuchi away, FNG, no Firefly, no four-star, and he goes into the side shop. Yoku tracking him down. He's got the scent, the wall from Aloha. Envy is locked, he can't get out. It's a team wipe. Virtus Pro, they are taking a commanding lead now here in game 3.
They got the Weaver. That was the one hero they had trouble with. He is going to go BKB now because he's finally realizing it's past that point. I'm getting nuked down. I'm getting blown up, and the fight was just completely won by FNG. That was the most beautiful force I've ever seen. The stun comes on the Ursa, and just as he was throwing his arms up, pushes him away, and that means everything Secret did to initiate is wasted. Easiest fight for VP to turn that around with gold advantage and experience advantage. Like
thank God they can do it again. The Observable and Scouts Puppy moving over, and Yoku, he don't care what's untouchable. He's all over it.
Yeah, he's buying Ags as well. This is actually a pretty rare game with his worth it, because you can use this while you're stunned. It lowers the cooldown as well, and the stun he's looking to stop, Lion disables or
DK.
Dragonite stun. It doesn't work when you're hexed though, because that kind of counts as a silence. So that's the only way that they can lock down Ursa with Chronosphere. But if it's Dragonite like that, boom, pop your ulti and you're going to tank it up, and the fight should go well for you. So now he can be like, he can play a sort of like tanky, basically like what Dragonite wishes he could do this game. You take the focus of the brunt and the stuns, and you're going to turn around and provide space for your team and your tanker to do damage.
I just still cannot believe how unbelievably big the VP cores are. With 12-1, 8, 7-1, 11 on the Tinker and Ursa respectively. Hey, this is just, it's massive for them. And Weaver being the only one, when you got to go a defensive item like this, he can't turn the tides of the fight yet. You almost need to buy like another 10-15 minutes for Eternal Envy. One, to finish his BKB, and two, build into the MKB.
And the supports are pretty rich on VP, especially Disruptor. He's got a Ghost Scepter now. Like, Weaver can't touch him anymore. Disruptor is not dying no matter what. The only person that he can get kills on is No Fear on Earth Spirit, who doesn't have actually anything. But it's got levels. That's all he needs.
They're pinning out again. VP had got so much information from this Observer Ward in the mid lane, but Puppy just gets munched. A double damage rune Ursa. You can say goodbye to that tier 2 town. There's no defending this for Team Secret.
I mean, I'm so surprised that he keeps the previous death, whatever. You're in the jungle warding, but that one he's standing by creep waves. Didn't really know where VP was, and Yoku again is able to get a kill on the Enchantress. It's the easiest thing ever. There's nothing Enchant can do to stop that other than not standing there.
I'm surprised VP aren't forcing the issue. They're not going for the tier 2 tower. It's like they're waiting for Roshan. Yeah. He's up in about 15 seconds.
They put no fear in there to scout it. And I honestly don't think they need to. Like, they're so far ahead right now, they don't want to throw the sleep. Like, look at the net worth. Dragonite's like 7k ahead of DK, and he counters the hero. I mean, yeah, he bought an egg, so maybe 1,000, 2,000 of that gold is wasted a bit, but they're so far ahead, they don't want to do it.
Patience. Don't. There you go. Now they instantly know Roshan's up. He moved out like 3 times.
Immediately they're TPing in, and they're going to be there for this.
Yeah. Well, how long does it take? Like, Yoku can finish this thing in maybe, like, what, 20 seconds
can,
by himself?
But you don't want to throw.
No, you
Patience
don't.
Is the play. They don't really know where Secret is right now.
Well, they're observable as Zeusi a lot, but they don't see... they see an Enchantress creep right now.
They also don't have a gem, so they don't really know where Secret's wards are, but they know at least that Secret's wards are likely on their side of the map.
It's already done.
Kept them together.
Roshan's into the hands of Virtus Pro. And they give the Aegis Immortal, of course, it's into the hands of the Ursa.
Yep.
And it's a 5-man smoke from Secret, so it looks like they're going to prepare themselves a trap over on the Dire Jungle. Just the hillside up from the tier 2 tower is Virtus Pro. They move into the mid lane. You're going to fight into a team who has Aegis Immortal and 2 waste marching machines down. No fear will die. Aloha Dance will join him.
They
if they can get
him.
The damage, they still haven't done the job. Finger of Death, there they go. Envy with a double kill. But you've got a big, big Ursa looking for an opening. Eternal Envy, your time limits off all the damage to be done to him. VP, they've lost 3 heroes, but they still have the 2 major cores. So Secret, they take the fight, but they don't burn Aegis. And they don't take the 2 big ones.
It's still really good considering how behind Secret is. They're going to be absolutely happy with that. And a great play by Yoku to get out. I thought he was going to keep fighting. He had Aegis, but there was just going to increase the chances that he got burnt out and kited and eventually killed. And then VP would lose a lot of advantage. So still a great fight for Secret, but they get Roche. They got cheese. Did they even use the cheese there?
No,
they
it's over
not.
On the Batrider.
So he still got the cheese. He's got a Shadowblade now.
Yep.
Because this is like the most free game to get it. Yeah. He doesn't have to worry about BKB. He's so far ahead of his opponents, and now he can look for those kills, get the lasso off, force staff afterwards, get a way out. G didn't die either. Like, Necro or Dagon 4 right now. 1,000 gold in the bank.
It's the big ones. I also love the fact like you're able to amplify him up by having the Veil of Discord over an Aloha Dance, so he knows exactly who they're going to fight on, and then it's just a quick pop.
Yeah, and that was all of their focus. They chronoed 2 supports. They used almost all of their nukes on Disruptor, and he just barely died.
Yeah.
Barely. If he gets, I don't know, an Ags or something, is he ever going to die?
I don't know.
And this is like, every single fight has been, and this is from the start of the game, he's been surviving with like 17 Wand Charges. Every time he barely survives, and this adds up to where he is now, with all of these items, with tons of kills.
The funny thing is, though, he's still the 3rd lowest net worth on the field. Outrider has picked up so much, like, we've been seeing already FNG making the most out of his items.
Yeah.
But the fact he's already got this much, and if he does finish up something like a Silver Edge, potentially he can actually make TZ even weaker, because there's no BKB on this Dragon Knight yet. He's managed to get the recipe as well as the Yoga Club. You can also look for the break chance on Dragon Blood.
Yeah, that'd be pretty nice to have. Are you talking about Batrider using it?
Yeah, I'm actually thinking about Batrider getting to a point like that.
He just gets BTs
and just gets BKB or something.
Well, that's you just talked about like 7,000 gold of items just now. Be like, oh yeah, BTs, BKB, and then get a Silver Edge. Hey, Toby, the game might not go that long.
It may not. They're jumping in. They find the Dragon Knight. Dragon Tail Stun will happen. The Observer Ward's still there, however, which means Arteezy glimpsed back in and killed off. 1 minute without Arteezy.
They look like a support.
that's a mid.
It's Veil Dagon, man. He just died instantly. And that cost G nothing. Right back to farming, right back to pushing. Dagon 5's ready. And after this, it just gets worse. He's gonna have Hex, he's gonna have Shiva's Guard. Pretty soon they won't even be able to kill him, because he's gonna be so tanky. And even if they do catch him, if he's not stunned for one moment, he suicides. And all that gold advantage that Secret's working for to get on the Tinker, it just doesn't come their way.
Yep. And then actually instantly respawns as well, thanks to all the Bloodstone charges. They don't even get rid of him.
Yep, doesn't even have to buy back. Just so much advantage for VP right now.
How much are they actually looking at? It's about 7.5k in the net worth. They almost had 10k at one point. The experience is also up at 12k, but it's starting to creep back a little bit the way of Team Secret.
Okay. Happy to announce No Fear has finally finished an item. It's an Urn of Shadows. Big, big pickup, 35 minutes.
Yeah, because he bypassed the blade mail.
Yeah. It's like, hey, people are dying. I might as well get an urn, right, guys? Dine is definitely happening on the side of Secret. Sure.
It's just if it can continue to happen. Still haven't seen Envy get picked off. Like, he hasn't died in a very long time.
No,
like, that's
just that
one time
one
bot. Death.
But he's got to be careful. It's still dangerous. BKB solves all those problems. He doesn't have to worry about glimpse, static field, stuff like that. But
I just want to know what item he goes for, because he's got one more item slot before he has to start replacing like threats.
I think he has to go raw damage. I think like a hybrid tank item isn't what their team needs. They need to get kills, and they're definitely lacking on damage.
Well, do you go the EE special? Like, I'll have like a butterfly with a side of rapier.
That kind of works, but only until he gets the rapier. If he gets butterfly now, I just feel like...
Oh, butterfly, butterfly is normally the thing, because you're playing a Weaver, right? So you don't need to lock into the treads. You can use both Flutter and Shikuchi.
Okay, that's a good point, but you're still talking about like three items deep at that
that's
point.
That's very true.
Like, the butterfly doesn't solve his problems right now. He needs damage. Butterfly gives you survivability. It will give him an edge against Ursa, but Ursa could go to the shop right now and buy an MKB if he sees that item picked up on Weaver. I think Weaver honestly needs just more raw damage, whether we're talking Daedalus or MKB. Daedalus would synergize better with Death, so it's more likely, but
what's on the...
could be lots of stuff.
You're right, it's the Daedalus. He's got most of it sitting back on the curry at the moment.
Biggest raw damage you can get without committing to a rapier.
They're using EE as bait. They put down the Tinker
really
Ward,
careful.
They put Pilot Eye in the tree line. But like, yeah, when he time-lapses like that, you know EE is running scared.
Again, he has to be. Batrider could be set up. Batrider grabs him. With the Blink Force Lasso, and Tinker kills him. It's easy. And it gets even harder once Tinker gets the scythe of his own, because then he can do it by himself. Blink, Dagon, Hex, Refresh, Repeat, and that's a dead Weaver.
And Team Secret, they got to find a way back. Wait for the Adam timings if you want to. At least they're not dealing with an Aegis the Immortal. That would be a ticket for VP to go, well, I want to say up.
Earth Spirit going back to treads now. That was his Robe of the Magi, finally putting it to use.
That's
like, I guess he just gave up on the blade and all. He's like, oh, we don't need this anymore. We're fine.
It's a scythe for Yoku.
Okay.
He's looking to solo kill everybody.
Yeah, he doesn't need damage that much. What they really need is the guaranteed lockdown against Weaver and Faceless Void. Those are the two that are a little scary. Plus this guarantees, I mean, he does have BKB already, but this way he can solo kill some of those heroes without having to use a BKB charge.
Envy, bring Corey back.
What do you want the...
I think Puppy was clicking on it to bring his wind lace to him.
More important than the Daedalus, for sure.
Maybe a little bit.
Well, Enchant does have Ags now, so she's going to be doing some pretty good right-click damage. Her attack speed's real weak, though. That's one thing she's definitely missing.
They got to be careful with this for Eternal Envy, because he dropped his TP scroll to hold onto the Daedalus. So he can't instantly join the fights. And Arteezy, okay. He underneath the Observer Ward. The fresh one from Seek will be placed on down, so now they can see the reason why they lost their DK. But again, it's 1 minute without Artur.
He doesn't even have BKB still. He's got two items, but 1,300 away. They just don't feel comfortable anywhere. Farming heroes.
He's been at that point for 7 minutes.
He's had a really rough game. Just all of these nukes, man. It looked so good at the start. He got his items relatively fast. Good timing on Shadowblade, but never got a kill and kept getting blown up at the start in every fight because he had to be the one to run in. But if the fights go bad, man, and you're dying for it, this is the situation you're in when they have good gank heroes to keep you down after they beat you.
Pilot Eyes taking a leaf out of the AUI book. Almost expecting to be on a leaner at this point, hiding in the trees, waiting for Tinker to do this so he can blink in, do the damage, get the hell out, and then just TP back to base. Give some kind of momentum from a support. He's not waiting for any of his teammates to come up here. I think, yeah, okay, it's too risky for him now. Because no one can BT. This isn't a very maneuverable lineup from Team Secret
at
all.
It's not just about the BTs, though, because if he sits there top and maybe one VP hero pushes out, he can jump from the trees and try to catch them as they push back. And then they can actually collapse on it. So there's like multiple options. It's not just about the instant gank. It's about being in a position where you have the ability to cut off people as they retreat or maybe cancel TPs. And sometimes you don't get that opportunity, but what did he lose by being there? If Arteezy can't farm, Pilot Eye's not going to farm. So why not wait in the trees and see if there's maybe a chance?
Uh-huh. Pressure is coming in. The Shadow Blade from FNG looking for a target, but all of Team Secret currently are waiting on the bottom lane for Eternal Envy to get killed. Oh, stop Eternal Envy from getting killed.
He's got great items right now. His damage is very good, and you can crit on the Geminate attack, so...
Just need to be able to defend, like, that's the only thing, but no one's got a buyback, so what you see is what you got for Team Secret at the moment.
That's kind of how they have to play. They're so far behind that they can't just have gold sitting in their inventories. It would be too big of a percentage of what they're currently holding. So, constantly, they're pushing lanes with bugs. Batrider's always ready. If anyone comes to farm, they die. And that's why Arteezy still doesn't have BKB.
Yep.
It's the power of Batrider, man. What a hero to pick out on the third game.
That's wonderful for Virtus Pro. As long as they can hold the advantage, and it keeps going their way too, because Team Secret, right now, this is almost like a castle siege. Team Secret go in there and they just try and survive with their supplies while VP pillage their fields.
That was an interesting way to talk about the Dota game. That's all I'm gonna say about that.
Age of Empires is an inspiration.
Okay. Well, we all saw that Reddit thread today. I am pretty sure all of our viewers don't actually know of any other games than Dota 2.
That is very, very true. Dota forever, boys.
Yeah, you probably just alienated your viewer base, if anything, that you played something else.
I have better ways of doing that.
Yeah, you really do. We saw it 30 minutes ago.
Yeah, love you, Purge.
That wasn't done for me. That was done despite yourself, really. You're hurting yourself, Toby. So, Tinker's really farmed now. 4k gold. I guess we've said that all game, huh? But
we really have. It's like what he goes into. Like we haven't seen actually a new item over on God for a while.
Well, that's because Dagon 5 is the most expensive item in the game. For good reason. It's amazing on Tinker because essentially you get to use it multiple times in a team fight. You're only limited by mana. That's it.
Okay, Eternal Envy. I hold my breath. When you BT onto a catapult in the mid lane, which is almost at the river end, right in front of like three heroes of Virtus Pro, they don't jump because you just instantly shikuchis.
Still a little scary here.
Team Secret are trying to find out anything they possibly can. They just use their scan over on the Dire Ancients. They're trying to find out if VP are just sitting back farming. Like, Roshan is now up, so this is obviously the next place to go. This will mean that VP will have two cheeses and one Aegis.
But this is the hard part. If you look at their vision, they have almost nothing. The only wards they can get away with are ones on cliffs.
Are they smoking?
I don't even think they know. Like, Secret has amazing... Alright, literally they always know. I don't know how, but they always know.
It's too late. Like, they know, but it's too late. Unfortunately, yeah. They didn't break the Enigma code fast enough.
Yeah, and that's another cheese.
Yeah,
we're gonna see a pause.
Hold the phone.
Yeah, I can relate to that. Once you finally move up to a high FPS monitor, when it drops down to 60, it feels really laggy. And especially if you're playing Batrider, you got to initiate, you got to get those lassos off fast. Your game feels off. If you're not used to the FPS, brain is focusing on understanding what's happening rather than focusing on lassoing somebody. It makes a huge impact at this level of play, for sure.
Well, it's a big time for a Team Secret with this five-man smoke up mid. But they still have to get vision on VP to get a good gank.
Oh, yeah. But they also have an Aegis and two cheeses, so they've got a lot of area to take this advantage. Like, if they don't finish somebody off in the chrono,
yeah,
guaranteed.
You almost want to like focus on some. No, you don't, because like
gotta kill Bat first. That's the big one.
But even if you kill Bat, like he can just buy back into the game. He can't necessarily rejoin them because he can't buy his BT straight after he buys back.
Okay, you're definitely right about that. That's a big thing. But kill Bat first.
Actually,
BKB heroes out of position.
That back. He actually can buy his BTs after he dies.
He's got the money.
He's got the cash.
Well, if they can kill Batrider, stop the lasso, and the teamfight ultimates are a bit wasted from VP. Haven't seen it yet, but maybe. Then they have to kill Tinker and the other three heroes.
I don't even want to fight yet.
Twice.
If they can actually give Alohan Dance a little bit more time, he's 700 gold away from having the Aghanim Scepter. Obviously, they can fight. There's nothing that stops them from doing this. And Team Secret, okay, that Obs,
Disruptor.
The Obs and Sentry, they know the Dire Observer Ward is there and they're coming up. Yoku,
they see the fire.
He can actually be locked in by Pylite Dye and taken out this fight, while Chronosphere will isolate Alohan Dance, but DK still so low, he'll kill off FNG. And now there's a Team Secret actually picking their targets really nicely. Yoku, he's still not involved in the fight. Your Aegis, the Immortal Carrier, was zoned out by just a lion, and Universe taking up all the damage. You'll throw down the Disruptor only from Alohan Dance, but the damage from Envy was still good enough. Universe wants to chase further. He's got Blink and Diffusal available, so he can slow down one hero if he time walks forward. He does not want to do that. Up against an Ursa, who is waggling his tail, hoping they'll fight, and now they're actually forced to. Universe pulls back, Pylite Dye, the Space Creator, but not enough space. Now it's Eternal Envy. They have to find a kill. Go Scepter, slowing it down so Disruptor can stay alive and allowing God to rip in the damage. Now the Aegis will go for Pumpy, almost for 100%, down to 10. The Dagon will snipe him out. Envy will start his own TP out to safety now. It looked like a good fight to start there from Team Secret, but then they chased VP a little bit too far.
I think it was overall pretty good for them. They got a lot of kills. I don't think there was a buyback yet. There was no buyback from Tinker. That was just his really fast Bloodstone respawn. And Glimpse back was really what forced them to commit, though. They were happy to get out. They had a great team fight considering their position, but the Glimpse committed the Weaver, or I'm sorry, the Faces Void, and they killed him afterwards due to the Ags on Ursa. He would have lived, but he popped his ult and it removed the stun, and that was allowed him to finish off the Void, and then they were just committed because Tinker was back up. It was a great turnaround for VP to commit them to the fight. And again, Disruptor pays off time and time again.
He's got a fresh item. It's the Scythe of Vice now.
He needed that too, because you saw Weaver does a lot of damage right now. Those crits, man.
It's the fact too that Envy can keep running around after his BKB wears out.
Yeah, and be invisible. And normally I wouldn't expect Weaver to do this much damage, but the Tinker didn't go an armor item yet. It's a very atypical core. Ooh. Normally any core would be like, oh, I'll buy an armor item. But he actually dies really fast to the Weaver. Careful.
Oh, here it is, Eternal Envy. Divine Rapier is now sitting over on the Weaver. We are at that time.
I like it. This is actually pretty incredible. He can two-shot Tinker. So that's going to be the target, really.
You know his upside? Like, I don't know if they're buying a new one straight away. The fact that Pylite Die has that stolen gem.
Okay. So, some much-needed map control. Now they can stand together on the map rather than in their base. So at least they'll gain some resources from this.
I'm still worried about Aloha Dancer's farm time.
Okay.
He's just about to finish up with this camp. He now actually has his Aghanim Scepter, and if Secret unaware of this, their items may mean absolutely nothing.
Which is really important now because Arteezy's got BKB finally. Sells his bottle.
That would be the ultimate insult if DK actually gets caught inside the Static Storm and cannot use a 10-second BKB.
Yeah, that would be really tough. I'm doubting FNG's Shadowblade a little bit right now. I really think he needs to have BKB. Keeps blinking in aggressively. He's getting his lassos off, but he's getting on to afterwards and sometimes killed. So I really would like to see him not have to worry about those kind of spells, especially from like Lion. I guess Chrono hits him anyways, but some survivability would be good.
It's probably expecting the racks to be down by now that have a little bit more money up his sleeve to actually finish the BKB.
Yeah, and now that I'm looking at it, like Weaver's still gonna kill him if he's BKB'd. He's still gonna get disabled by Lion. Impetus is still gonna, or we won't get disabled by Lion, but he's Impetus will still go through it, so maybe it's not the best solution here. Scepter is probably the best, easily. Impetus stops Weaver, right clicks. Only thing is he'll get stopped.
Arteezy, can he see him? Can he see him? He's so close! Smell the aftershave Tinker is currently wearing, but unfortunately he just can't stun that. And now the rest of VP are gonna come over, and Arteezy has to run away. He's got a lot of support behind him, however. The entire of Team Secret's life is hoping that VP actually come out to try and initiate him without full force.
They're ready to fight. Lots of buybacks on these guys as well.
If FNG actually gets the flying vision up here, because there's no ward. That's what he's looking for with a sticky napalm.
Oh,
flies up, he sees them all, jumps in, grabs the DK. March Machine cover fire is there, and well, Chronosphere, it actually caught No Fear and Aloha Dance on the back lines, but you've already lost Arteezy. Yurku's gonna go ham until Universe can just bounce himself out with that Time Warp and Eternal Envy. BKB charge. Oh, that Batrider explodes, but the Ghost Scepter over on God, they're gonna kill him off. It's a double kill for Eternal Envy. Yurku's dropping quickly as well, but Aloha, now the ulti will go down Eternal Envy. Down the rapier, it's on the deck. Eternal Envy, buyback timeless is in, but the rapier's already gone. It's on No Fear. The Earth Spirit currently is dealing about 440 damage a pop. Aloha's on the run. Puppy needs his kill. The Ghost Ships are causing troubles, and a pause will come as Arteezy has crashed.
Oh no, he can't buy back though. If this was a pub, they'd be like, no problem, dude. He can't be there anyways.
Just keep going.
Resume it. The Rapier. He almost got it, too. I thought it was over, but the time lapse, he was so close. But No Fear was all about that. He was watching him. He said, he's about to die. I'm going to pick this up, and we win the game. Because all of a sudden, the net worth on Envy is way lower than it was before. He picked off the Tinker, though. Some huge kills there. It's very difficult. He can just refresh his Ghost Scepter just about endlessly.
Yep.
But they picked him off, and he didn't have buyback in that fight. So if he could have grabbed that rapier, cleaned up the rest of the fight, they could have kept going. But now it's tough.
I actually don't even know if they can find themselves another kill. Like, Aloha Dance, Eternal Envy can push for it, but...
He's definitely dead, because they're Earth Spiking right now.
Ah, okay, yeah, that'll do it. But Yoku... Yoku doesn't turn for that. His scythe is down.
He's no ult for 7. It's just dangerous. Get your heroes back. You already stole a rapier. That's 6,000 gold advantage in the fight.
Yep.
Why commit to that? Just wait. Go back. Wait for your allies to respawn. Wait for Tinker to be alive. Did you see how Tinker started the fight? It was so incredible. He was out of position for the chrono, and he blinks out instantly, goes into the trees, plays it safe, dodges the chrono, is only on the two supports then, and that made all the difference there.
I think Universe was still happy with the early advantage they got because that Chronosphere.
That's pretty good. Yeah.
Like, it could keep Aloha out of the field. So Aloha, goodbye to your Ghost FD. That's going to lose the gem, and Yorku does! SP! He's down! 2 minutes, that's a dieback! Aloha will survive! And now it's going to be Puppy as well! Oh boy! Team Secret, thought they had the kill. They thought they had the kill, and then Yorku just pulls up the britches.
They went back in. I mean, the biggest thing was that the Ghost Scepter still lasted for like 2 seconds. So Envy's standing around being like, all right, any moment now I'll get the kill.
They needed the Diffuser Blade from Faceless Void, something to allow them to instantly attack. And now Yorku, like you see his army picks up. Like you could have gone for anything and he goes refresh roll. We've got double BKBs. We've got double Ags in Rage as well. Double Scythes.
That's really good, actually. 10 seconds guaranteed BKB. Plus, you can remove a stun with your ult and hex twice. What a good build.
It's the Immortal Bear, and what a hero as well for Virtus Pro. If they can win this game on the back of, like, their hero.
FNG salving up Yorku because they know that this is their time to go. With Envy dying, he's dead for 60. He bought back before.
Oh, they buy everything.
So they're trying to go high ground, and they're healing him up as much as they can.
Look, they try and survive. Good luck,
they got
Universe,
Dragon.
The lasso, they find a target, Dragon Knight, Universe, the chrono will come, but DK's already down, God's not caught inside of this one, he can just keep going to work, Universe, he's down so low, this could be
That's
it, there's too many
it.
Heroes lost, Puppy will die as well, there's just nothing more in the tank, GG,
no way.
Team Seeker in the lower bracket, Virtus Pro will get a date with Evil Geniuses to handle and keep themselves at the lower bracket, can they actually keep Secret and EG down?
This is the biggest upset in months, I think.
The whole series as well from like game two. The fact that this happened and then the instant follow-up with game three, Team Secret losing that one as well.
Absolutely.